dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So before summative assessment, we were discussing about our lesson, that is what? Microorganism, friend and foe. In that, our last point is remaining, that is what? Nitrogen cycle. So without wasting a time, let's move for the last point from the lesson, that is what? Nitrogen cycle. So what is mean by nitrogen cycle? Which things involved in the nitrogen cycle? Which are the microorganisms which are responsible for the nitrogen cycle? That all the things we are going to discuss in this point. Okay, so let's discuss about nitrogen cycle. But the main thing is that why does nitrogen is important? Okay. Nitrogen cycle is there, but is it necessary the nitrogen is important? Yes, so the nitrogen is important for the protein synthesis in the plant. Also, it is responsible for the nucleic acid, or it is important for the formation of the nucleic acid. So in this way, we can say that what nitrogen is important for the formation of protein in the plant, amino acid and the nucleic acid. Okay, so let's discuss what is mean by nitrogen cycle. The circulation of nitrogen through living things, very important. What the circulation is there? Circulation means what? Circle is there among whom? Between the or through the living thing. Living things like what? Plants and animals. And non-living environment, that is air, soil and water, is called nitrogen cycle. So there is a circulation of the nitrogen from the living things and the non-living things, and that cycle is called as what? Nitrogen cycle. So what the circulation of nitrogen through living things like plants and animals and the non-living things like air, soil and water is called nitrogen cycle. So this nitrogen cycle involves the certain types of the process. Which are that process? First process is what? Nitrogen fixation. Next one is nitrogen assimilation. Third one is ammonification. Third, fourth one, nitrification. And the last one, denitrification. So all this process we are going to see deeply one by one. So first we will start with the first step of the nitrogen cycle, that is what? Nitrogen fixation. Okay, so what is mean by nitrogen fixation? Let's see. The conversion of free atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogenous compound is called nitrogen fixation. Okay, so as we know, in the atmosphere the highest amount of the gas is what? Nitrogen gas. So there is a 78% nitrogen is present in the atmosphere, but that nitrogen cannot get utilized by the plant as it is. Okay, so that 70% gas is present, but that is not useful for the plant for the synthesis of the protein. They require the simple form of the nitrogen for the formation of the protein, and that is the reason the nitrogen cycle is important, or there is a necessity of the nitrogen fixation. Okay, so what is meant by the nitrogen fixation? The conversion of free atmospheric nitrogen, the conversion of free atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogenous substance or the nitrogenous compound is called nitrogen fixation. Okay, so this nitrogen fixation is happens by the two ways. First one is what? Lightning. Okay, so let's see the first way of the nitrogen fixation, that is what? Lightning. So whenever it is lightning, or whenever lightning strike, that time the oxygen and the nitrogen get reacts with each other, and that forms the oxides of nitrogen. Okay, so when the lightning strike, that time what happens? The nitrogen and the oxygen get react with each other and then forms the oxides of nitrogen. These oxides of the nitrogen get mixed into the rainwater, and then that oxides of the nitrogen get converted into nitric acid. Okay, then get converted into nitric acid. Nitric acid get combined or get mixed into the limestone, which is present in the soil, and then it get converted into nitrates. Okay, again I will repeat, whenever it lightnings, or whenever the lightning strike, that time oxygen and the nitrogen get react, they found the oxides of nitrogen. That oxides of the nitrogen get combined with the rainwater and then it forms the nitric acid. This nitric acid get mixed into the limestone from the soil and then at the final it get converts into nitrates. And then it get utilized by the plants with the help of the water. This nitrate again get dissolved into the plant and with the help of the root system the plants are using these nitrates. Okay, so this is the first way of the nitrogen fixation. Now we will discuss about the biological nitrogen fixation that already we have seen in our previous in lesson number 1, but again we will discuss that is what biological nitrogen fixation. So as we know there are the certain plants like beans, peas are there. In short we can say that there are the leguminous plants and that leguminous plants contains the nodules on its roots. They are called as what? Root nodules. And that root nodules, one type of the bacteria is living, that is what? Rhizobium bacteria. So that rhizobium bacteria helps to convert the atmospheric nitrogen into the simple form of nitrogen compound. Okay, so this rhizobium bacteria absorbs the atmospheric nitrogen, it mix into the soil or it get converts into the nitrogen compound or the useful nitrogen compound and then it get utilized by the plants. Okay, so here we have discussed about the rhizobium bacteria. Rhizobium has our bacteria helps to convert the atmospheric nitrogen into the nitrogenous compound. And after that there are the certain cyanobacteria are there, that is what? Nostoc and the Anabaenia. These are the, also the bacteria which are helps to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. Okay, so from this nitrogen cycle up till now we have discussed the first step, that is what? Nitrogen fixation, which is happens with the help of the two stair. There are the two ways for the nitrogen fixation, that are lightning and the biological nitrogen fixation. Now we will move for the next step in the nitrogen cycle, that is nothing but what? Nitrogen assimilation. Okay, so now let's discuss about the next step in the nitrogen cycle, that is nitrogen assimilation. So as we know, the nitrogen is used by the plants for the synthesis of protein, and that synthesis of the protein is we can call them as a plant protein. So whenever the herbivorous plant animals are eating the plants, then what happens? That plant's protein get enters into the herbivorous animals. Okay, when the herbivorous animals are eating the plants, okay, then you have what happened with the help of that plants, the protein also enters in our their body and the plant's protein get converted into the animal's protein. So in this way what happened? Whenever that herbivorous animals will eaten by the carnivorous animal, then again it will get transferred into them. So in this way what happened? The nitrogen cycle get continues from the plants to the animals, and that only called as what? That process is only called as what? Nitrogen assimilation. Let's discuss about the definition of nitrogen assimilation. The process of conversion of inorganic nitrogen compounds into organic compounds that becomes a part of a living organisms is called nitrogen assimilation. Means what? The transfer of the nitrogen and the utilization of the nitrogen by the living organism. Again I will repeat, the process of conversion of inorganic nitrogen, the process of conversion of inorganic nitrogen compounds into organic compounds that becomes a part of living organism, that becomes a part of the organisms, living organism, that remains in the living organism, and that is only called as what? Nitrogen assimilation. Okay, so this is the next steps in the nitrogen cycle. Now we'll discuss about the third steps in the nitrogen cycle, that is what? Ammonification.
So now what happens in the ammonification? When the plants and the animals get died, then what happens? With the help of the decomposers like a fungi and a certain bacteria, that nitrogen is again get mixed into the atmosphere, and that process is called as what? Ammonification. It is known as what? Ammonification. So whenever the plants and the animals get die, so that protein in that plants and animals get converted into the ammonium compounds with the help of the certain decomposers like fungi and the bacteria, and that process is called as what? Ammonification. Okay, so we can say the, or we can say the definition of the ammonification is that what? The conversion of complex organic compounds like proteins into ammonia. Okay, so the proteins which are present in the plants and the animals body get converted into ammonium compounds with the help of the decomposers, and that process is called as what? Ammonification. So this is the fourth steps in the nitrogen cycle. Now we'll move for the fourth steps in the nitrogen cycle, that is what? Nitrification. So what happens in the nitrification? Let's see. So in the nitrification, first the ammonium salts get converted into nitrides. Okay, the ammonium salt which is get released during when the animals or the plants get died. Okay, that time what happen? Ammonium compounds get released, and after that next process is what? Nitrification. So in the nitrification what happens? Whatever the ammonium products are getting released, that is what? Ammonium salts. That ammonium salts get converts into nitrites with the help of the nitrosomonas bacteria. Okay, with the help of the nitrosomonas bacteria, the ammonium salt get converts into nitrites. Next one, these nitrides get converted into nitrates. These nitrides get converted into nitrates with the help of the nitrobacter bacteria. Okay, nitrobacter bacteria. So in this way, this nitrosomonas and the nitrobacter bacteria, these both the bacteria are called as what? These both the bacteria are called nitrifying bacteria. Okay, these are called as what? Nitrifying bacteria. So once these nitrates is formed, it again get mixed into the soil, it again get formed into the soil, and again it get utilized by the, again it get absorbed by the plants. Okay, so in this way these nitrification processes happen, or that process is called as what? Nitrification. So what is the definition of nitrification? The conversion of ammonia into nitrates is called nitrification. Okay, so what is more? Nitrification, the conversion of ammonia into nitrates is called nitrification. So this is the fourth steps involved in the nitrogen cycle. And now we will discuss about the last step, that is what? Denitrification. What is meant by denitrification? So once the nitrate get combines into the soil, some of the nitrates is get utilized by the plant, and the rest of the nitrogen, what about that? The rest of the nitrates, the rest of the nitrates get again converted into nitrogen gas with the help of the Pseudomonas bacteria. Okay, so with the help of this Pseudomonas bacteria, the rest of the nitrogen gets converted into nitrogen gas and get released into the atmosphere. So, and that process is called as what? Denitrification. So, what is the definition of the denitrification? The conversion of nitrates into free nitrogen gas by denitrifying bacteria like what? Pseudomonas bacteria is called denitrification. Okay, so this is the last step in the nitrogen cycle. So with the help of the nitrogen cycle, the amount of the nitrogen in the atmosphere is remains the constant, less or more. Okay, so in this way, in short, we can say that with the help of this nitrogen cycle, the nitrogen, the amount of the nitrogen in the atmosphere remains the constants. Okay, so So this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the nitrogen cycle and different process or different steps involved in the same. So this is all about today. Today we have finished your lesson. We will meet in the next video with the new point. Until then, goodbye.